Welcome everyone to Monash University's Faculty of Law and to the Annual Castan Centre for Human Rights Law Conference. You are all welcome today, and I am particularly pleased to welcome back to Monash Law my former Dean, Emeritus Professor Rosalind Croucher. Before we begin, I would like to acknowledge that I am speaking from the unceded land of the people of the Kulin Nations, and I pay my respects to their elders past and present. I extend that acknowledgement and respect to all Aboriginal and Torres Strait Islander peoples here today and to the elders past and present of the lands from which all participants are joining this conference. As a law faculty, we also acknowledge and respect that the people of the Kulin Nations and the Indigenous peoples of this country have the world's oldest continuing jurisprudential tradition. Monash Law is a world-leading law school, and we operate from 7 locations worldwide, with a main campus at Clayton in Melbourne, a CBD chambers in the city, and 3 clinical sites of operation and 2 offshore campuses in Prato and Malaysia. We aim to be a leading international, clinical, and digitally engaged law school in the Indo-Pacific region as part of a research-intensive Geo8 university with transnational campuses and alliances and strategic ambitions to address the global challenges of climate change, geopolitical security, and thriving communities. Of course, all of those 3 global challenges implicate human rights of the most vulnerable, marginalized, disempowered, and discriminated against people and communities locally, nationally, and worldwide. At Monash Law, our researchers and our PhD students contribute to research quality and research impact through 3 university-approved research centres: the Centre for Commercial Law and Regulatory Studies, the Australian Centre for Justice Innovation, and of course the Castan Centre for Human Rights Law, long the jewel and the crown of the Monash Law faculty. We also engage in research quality and impact through emerging research groups in transnational criminal law, capital punishment justice, commercial dispute resolution, public sector law and governance, feminist legal studies, and now artificial intelligence, technology, and the law. Indeed, the combined work and standing of the clinical program and our clinical guarantee, the Castan Centre, and Eleos Justice on the death penalty, to mention just 3 of our research critical masses, together make Monash Law a considerable force for access to justice for those who most need it. The Castan Centre, a trusted Australian and global voice on human rights, promotes and protects human rights through law and justice via its world-renowned public scholarship, partnering, and community engagement, working in key areas of research, teaching, publication, policy, and student programs. It actively participates in public debates, including actions on the Voice to Parliament, and mentors many of the human rights leaders of tomorrow. Each year, the annual Castan Centre for Human Rights Law Conference brings together national and international human rights experts, including scholars, practitioners, and advocates from a wide range of disciplines, in order to promote and engage in public education and policymaking and lawmaking law reform discussion on human rights. This year is no exception, as you can see from the exceptional program that the Castan Centre and its organisers and members have put together. We are thrilled as a faculty with the exceptional depth of knowledge and experience that the 14 panelists and keynote speakers that are joining us today will share with us all. It gives me great pleasure to formally open the annual Castan Centre for Human Rights Law Conference. It truly is an honour to welcome these leaders in the human rights domain to come together and contribute their voice to our conference, and I thank them on behalf of the whole faculty and the university for their efforts across many time zones in being here to participate today. Without further ado, please allow me to introduce you two and hand over to Professor Melissa Castan, Director of the Castan Centre for Human Rights Law, as well as Associate Dean for Academic Staffing in the Faculty of Law. And I hand over to her for the official Castan Centre welcome and opening of the conference.
Thank you, Bryan, for your very warm support for the work that we're doing and continuing to go forward with. We really do appreciate the support. As mentioned, of course, I think many of you know me. I'm Melissa Castan. I'm the director of the Castan Centre for Human Rights Law. And I hold some other roles as well in the law faculty, as Bryan mentioned. I feel that I have seemed to have dedicated my professional life to the field of working in public law and human rights law. And I wanted to reiterate and extend on the acknowledgement that Bryan has already said to us this morning. I would like to specifically acknowledge the Wurundjeri and Bunurong people of the Kulin Nation as the ongoing custodians of the lands where Monash stands and where I'm joining you from. I wanted to particularly acknowledge the traditional owners' continuing relationship, not just to the land and waters, but also to the law and the continuing fight for justice in this country. And I wanted to observe that as teachers and as law practitioners and as educators, I feel we have a really important role in addressing the dispossession caused and the continuing impact of what we call, or what I've called, Captain Cook's Law as it applies across Australia. I wanted to make the observation that it's over 30 years since the High Court handed down the Mabo case decision, and it's over 25 years since the Bringing Them Home report was finalised by Sir Ronald Wilson and Professor Mick Dodson. These are just a couple of key steps. There have been many, many others, but in our national journey from that moment of Captain Cook's arrival and the law that came from Britain to the lands of Australia, in that journey from there to the restoration of proper legal relations between First Nations and the settler state of Australia. So I'm very much looking forward to the next step in that journey, and I've been very involved in speaking publicly on the referendum and the implementation of the Voice to Parliament at the federal level. And I really hope that we, as members of the legal, human rights and education and advocate communities, can really intentionally and actively participate in this legal and political reform. That's probably enough of my advertising, although I've got a few more official messages to give you. We are genuinely pleased to welcome all of you to our annual conference. I've lost track, and somebody's going to write into the chat, Julie Jebeljack, tell me, is this our 21st or 22nd conference in a row? Each year we endeavour to provide a global and domestic health check, I guess, on the state of human rights protection, bringing together the leading academics, practitioners, advocates and activists to bring all of us up to date on issues that are affecting us. This year's conference, we're highlighting issues of reproductive rights, of prevention of torture, the federal human rights framework that we're looking forward to, and issues of climate activism and protest. Across a wide range of human rights issues, we seek to influence government policy and practice for the benefit of communities. We want to provide accessible public information on current and important issues, and I will draw your attention to our Castan Centre Voice for Parliament resource page, which is rapidly filling up with excellent, reliable and thoughtfully produced materials on the conversation about the referendum. It is indeed my honour to be able to lead the Castan Centre at the moment and to continue to advocate for a more just world and a place where we think human rights can be properly respected and protected, and allow all peoples to pursue lives in freedom and with dignity. This year, we have been particularly focused, thank you, Julie, always on your toes. We have particularly been focused on our public education and research outputs in the issues arising under the Voice to Parliament proposal, research and advocacy related to the Royal Commission on Robo-Debt and the associated impacts of that, issues of women's reproductive health rights, data privacy, mental health, law reform, climate change, and the rights of older people. But that's just a small sample of the things we've been working on. We have also continued to run our human rights law clinic with really excellent, outstanding, motivated law students. Continues a long-standing practice of providing really invaluable guidance and seeding experience to the next generation of human rights leaders. And we're very proud of the work we've done there. So I want to welcome everybody who's joining us online. We did want to broadcast again online this year to allow people from across the globe and across the country to be in the room with us. We do miss meeting up in person. And we have, for people who are in Melbourne, a meet up at the end of the day so that we can still actually be in touch with each other at a more physical level. I want to make special mention of our continued sponsorship by our very good friends at Maurice Blackburn Lawyers, who as major sponsors have helped make today possible, and their continued support over many, many years is of so much value to us. And unrealisingly, it's also a value to you as our audience, because their support is really making this capacity to do this work possible. We do raise most of our income from beyond the university, and that's thanks to fundraising efforts and revenue raised from various events and consulting activities. So if I was to put it very simply, we cannot continue to do what we do without our human rights champions who put their hands in their pockets. So I want to thank everybody today who chose or elected that their workplace would pay for their tickets for today. Every dollar that we receive from you leads to more public impact, leads us to help develop a more human rights respecting society, and helps us do our work to the very best ability that we can. So we depend on your generosity, and we very much hope you'll be able to continue supporting us with your generosity. Thank you so much for your contributions at whatever levels they are. Now, as you've seen in the chat, our audience members today are drawn from local, interstate and international places, from the legal profession, from the human rights sector, from government and academia. Law students from universities across Australia are joining us today. So I'm so pleased that you can all be with us.